Legendary street six engines like the Toyota 2JZ, Nissan RB26, the Ford Barra, and even the BMW N54 have kind of been put up on this pedestal, and they're treated as the best engines ever. Now, previously we've made a video on the N54 and what makes it so special, but eventually BMW did replace it with the N55. So today we're going to dive in and tell you everything you need to know about the BMW N55. In 2006, when BMW dropped the N54, it was their first mass-produced turbocharged engine ever. Now, previously they had made turbocharged engines in small quantities, such as the M102 and the M106, but those were never mass-produced engines, so the N54 was a big first step for BMW, who had previously been known for producing really awesome naturally aspirated engines for many, many years. Not too long after BMW dropped the N54 in 2006, they started development of the N55, and they released the N55 in 2009-2010. Compared to the N54, the N55 has a significant amount of changes that were designed to make it more reliable, because the N54 did have a substantial amount of problems. While the N54 was BMW's first mass-produced turbocharged engine, the N55 was their first engine to use a twin-scroll turbocharger. To cover some basic information, the BMW N55 is a 3-liter all-aluminum inline-six engine. It features dual overhead cams, variable valve lift, and variable valve timing. Bore measures at 84 millimeters and stroke at 89.6 millimeters, which brings the total displacement up to 2,976 cc's. It also features the same 10.2-to-1 compression ratio as the N54. Not too surprisingly, this is the same bore, stroke, and total displacement as the BMW N54 before it. Now, as far as applications go, the N55 was used in a lot of different BMW vehicles, including the 135i, 335i, 535i, X1, X3, X5, 640i, 745, M235i, and so on. It was really used in pretty much everything BMW offered, from small coupes up to large SUVs, which is a testament to how versatile this engine is. Depending on the specific model that you're looking at, power output ranges from 302 horsepower and 295 pound-feet all the way up to 365 horsepower and 369 pound-feet. I know some of you might be thinking 302 horsepower or even 365 horsepower out of a 3-liter modern turbocharged engine, that's really not that much, and you'd be right. Fundamentally, that really is not all that much power considering it's a 3-liter engine and it's turbocharged. But BMW is not going to be trying to make some crazy record-breaking engine. They just wanted a good engine to use in their cars. And it's what's on the inside of the N55 that makes it so special. Working from the top down, let's take a closer look at the cylinder head first. As stated earlier, the N55 is an all-aluminum engine, which means the cylinder head is constructed from cast aluminum. Compared to cast iron, cast aluminum heads are much lighter and they offer far superior thermal performance, which is important because the cylinder head is a big determining factor for how much power your engine makes. The valve train is comprised of dual overhead cams driven by a timing chain with 4 valves per cylinder. This is all pretty standard stuff for a modern engine. And one of the big changes that BMW made when they went from the N54 to the N55 is the addition of Valvetronic. Both the N54 and N55 use BMW's Vano system on the intake and exhaust camshafts, but only the N55 uses the Valvetronic system, which allows for variable lift control. Having variable valve lift and variable valve timing is a huge benefit in terms of performance and efficiency. It can make tuning a little tricky if you don't know what you're doing, but the Valvetronic system is a great addition to the N55. Bolted to the side of the head, you will find a single twin-scroll turbocharger manufactured by BorgWarner. Now, not too surprisingly, the OEM turbo is pretty small, and really that's what you want for a street car. I know there's a lot of awesome videos of Supras, you know, taking 5 or 6 seconds to reach their boost threshold, but trust me, for a real street car, you don't want a laggy turbo or a turbo with a really high boost threshold. So that stock turbo is really, really good for the street. It makes a lot of low-end and mid-range power, and it's super responsive. Without getting into too much detail, the twin-scroll turbo can provide better throttle response and increased boost pressure compared through a single scroll turbo. Now, the reason BMW ditched the twin turbo system on the N54 in favor of the single turbo system on the N55 isn't totally clear to me, but single turbo systems are cheaper to manufacture, they're lighter weight, they're more thermally efficient, and they're way, way easier to package, so it kind of makes sense why BMW would ditch the twin turbo system in favor of a single turbo system. Moving from the head and turbocharger down to the block, we've got a cast aluminum block with an open deck design. And theoretically, this open deck design will make the N55 weaker than a closed deck engine, as we've discussed in previous videos, but really, that's not the big limiting factor on the N55. And if you really wanted to, there's a lot of closed deck conversion kits on the market, so you can make your N55 a closed deck if you're that worried about the open deck design. Inside the block, BMW unfortunately downgraded the N54 with its forged internals to the N55's cast internals. Now, this is something that you should take with a grain of salt, because although forged internals use superior material, the design of the internals is also a big factor when determining their strength. At the end of the day, yes, the N54 has stronger internals, but the N55's internals are still really, really strong. And upwards of 500 to 550 wheel horsepower, the N55 bottom end is really strong, and it's going to be more than enough. Unfortunately, every engine has its faults, and the N55 is no different. BMW did fix a lot of the issues that were found on the N54, but there are still a lot of issues on the N55, and some of them actually come from the N54. Now, one of the more unreliable parts on the N54 and the N55 is the electronic water pump, and while these have significant advantages over a mechanical water pump, they do break quite a bit more. Another common issue that you'll find is high pressure fuel pump failure, but that's mostly a problem on older models. The vanose solenoids are also known for failing prematurely, and the 2010 through 2012 engines are known for the bolts holding the vanose solenoid in. Those bolts are known for either breaking or just coming loose. As far as tuning potential goes, it's not too difficult to get an N55 with stock turbo up to 400 wheel horsepower and maybe 470 pound-feet of torque. Now, this is with a full bolt-on ethanol tune with a ton of boost, but if you wanted something more mild, you could really easily do a 330 wheel horsepower and 380 pound-feet tune really, really easily on pump gas. If you want more than 400 wheel horsepower, there are a lot of hybrid turbo options on the market, which is basically taking the stock turbo and making it a little bit better, which is going to give you much better throttle response than a full single big turbo. And it's also typically cheaper to buy a hybrid turbo than a brand new aftermarket turbocharger. Now, obviously, if you want to make big power, you're going to need either a big single turbocharger or a twin turbo system. And as far as I can tell, the N55 is really only going to be limited to about 500 to 550 wheel horsepower with a big single turbocharger. Past that, you are going to need aftermarket internals, but 500 wheel horsepower for a street car is plenty. That's a fast car. And like I said earlier, if you're wondering, yes, the N54 bottom end is stronger, but the N55's bottom end is still plenty strong. Fundamentally, it's actually pretty similar to the BMW N54, and it shares some of the parts, but it's kind of just an N54 that you make a little bit more reliable, although it's not as strong. So if you wanted some crazy high horsepower car, maybe the N55 isn't the best for you, but if you just want a street car, the N55 is a really awesome engine. So that's pretty much everything I have for you guys today. That's pretty much everything you need to know about the BMW N55. Let me know down in the comments below if you think it's better than the N54, or if maybe the 2JZ or the RB26. I kind of want to know where you guys think the N55 ranges in those legendary engines. While you're down there, smash the thumbs up button, hit subscribe so you don't miss out on future videos, and I'll see you guys in the next one.